I know exactly who you are as well, Lily Song.
Dun, dun, dun. Okay. Okay. I'm like,
I'm guessing you know who this is too, then.
I know who all three of you are. I did, after all, release you from prison.
Okay.
So were you explicitly releasing us, or just saying who you could get?
He's like, he kind of assesses you a little bit. You know, like you can see like the eyebrow of the eye area actually lift a little bit. And he goes, well, you were a coincidence. I was intending my target to be a specific six others.
Oh. Those guys.
However, I have to thank you. You three aided me in releasing them.
Okay.
What? We did?
Did
I thought we left them in...
I can't remember, but did I ever get the name of the guy that I was talking to that's all spoopy?
You do not. However, you do remember that a particular robot boy in your team or group was able to hack the security system and gain the knowledge of the six people in that room.
Okay. You know what? I'm going to be like, are you talking about the weird, creepy robots or the cool robots and the creepy voodoo guy and stuff?
I do intend those as my primary targets, and you guys helped release me. He looks over at the stock still Derwin, and he goes, with all the hacking that you did within their system, you weakened their security. He looks over at you, Wally, and he goes, and you drained the power, the remaining power, from their backup generators. And he goes, and he looks at little Lily, and he goes, and you, my dear,
you're
distracted
just
the warden while I was able to get them escape.
Okay. You mean the big poopy face?
Indeed.
Okay. Hey, do you know who that one guy is? And I kind of described to him the guy that was reading the book and stuff.
I do.
What's his story about?
Ah, information is valuable. And I do believe, if you talk to your little robot friend... that he will have just as much information as I do.
Okay, I'm going to walk up to Derwin and be like, hey!
As you stare into his face, he's about the same height as you as a little robot boy. You can see that the previously glowing eye sockets of LED lights are dim and not quite lit.
I'm going to smack him on the forehead, like... Hey!
Boom.
Yeah.
Doesn't work.
I think he's dead.
I'm gonna look at him, kind of all around. I'll be like, is he out of power or something? Does he need an AC power slot or whatever?
Who are you
saying
this to?
It's like just in general. I'm like. Is he like my Game Boy where I need to charge him?
Wally, do you have anything to say about this? Lord Recluse has nothing to say. There's just silence from him.
I'm going to look for an outlet.
There doesn't seem to be one
on the
helicopter pad.
Aren't you technically a giant battery?
Shh. I'm not at liberty to say.
Lord Recluse... kind of does one of those and drawing your attention to him. He goes, however, you did hijack one of my helicopters. Now, we have two issues at hand. I owe you for assisting in the release of some very valuable assets to my plans in the future. But you have also committed a criminal offense to Arachnos.
I'm going to look at him and go, do you have any cake?
No.
Oh, okay. I'm going to turn back to Dwimmer, Dwimer, whatever his name is.
Derwin.
I don't know why I can't remember his name.
Yeah, that guy.
That guy, that's a robot. That goes beep boop and fucks USB ports. All right, sorry, go.
Oh no.
Nope.
You
Nope.
said you turned back to him, so are
Yeah.
you saying anything to him or?
No, just the cake thing, and then I'm gonna turn back towards Derwin and focus my attention on him.
So he kind of like realizes that you don't give a shit that that Lord Recluse is talking to you. And he looks at Wally, realizing that he's for really any intents and purposes the adult of the group. At his ripe age of, I think it was 22, right?
Yep.
Yeah. At his ripe old age of adulthood at 22. And he turns around and goes, "Kill them," and disappears.
This is gonna be great. Like, just vanishes or walks away.
Like as he's walking away, he just,
Smoke bomb.
yeah, except for like no smoke bomb. He just literally like in thin air just
Oh, that's
as he's
not
walking away.
creepy at all.
As soon as he says that, all eight soldiers pull out weaponry from their backs
Da, da, da.
and point them at him. Roll initiative.
I guess that was too much of a I don't give a shit.
Dang it, where's the initiative button? There it is.
Okay. Wally, you get the first go. What are you gonna do?
Well, there we go. What do I want? There we go. Okay. Can't click. Need to. I'm assuming the dudes farthest away from me are the bigger bads, correct?
So essentially, from what you can gather, the two guys in the back that actually have the different look to them are the lieutenants.
Let's see. Can I? So they're. Do I already know what kind of weapons they're holding, or do I need to do some sort of perception check for that?
They look like assaulty type rifles, but of their actual make, they seem to be highly unique. It's not like a standard issue weapon that you've seen before. Particularly for you, this seems to be something a little bit beyond your immediate knowledge of this dimension.
Okay. I'm gonna huck the wait, no. Nate's holding the grenades, isn't he? Or
He
Derwin.
is.
Well, seeing as he's not doing anything,
He is unmoving.
can I take the grenades off his person?
Yes, if you can find them. Where would you like to check?
God dang it, flipping robot. Are they anywhere dangling on his, just hanging on him at all, or just?
He seems to have a couple like metal pouch component type things on his person, particularly more like a belt area, like a utility belt.
I will check the belt.
Okay. That would take you your entire turn to search his unmoving person and find those
I'll take
grenades.
it. I'll do
Okay.
it.
That's fine. So you immediately step over to him, thank you, and proceed to search him. In the course of your searching, you do find the grenades, which do you have the list or do you need me to read it out to you?
I'm taking one of the flashbangs.
Okay. So you just one of the flashbangs?
Just
You're
one.
not taking any of the other stuff?
I just want one flashbang.
Okay, no problem. Next up, lieutenants. They immediately focus upon your immediate group and fire off their rifles. One will fire at Lily, and one will be firing at Wally.
Is my back still turned to them, or at this point am I like facing them now?
No, you're facing them at this point.
Okay.
So that's the first one, Wally. Is that above your dodge plus 10?
Dodge plus 10. Yes.
Okay, and that hits. Lily, is that above your dodge plus 10? 19.
Yes.
Okay, then they both hit.
So I need to take an injury.
I now need you. No, not yet.
That's
to hit.
Oh, okay.
So these assault rifles, when you see them fire off, they efficiently, almost in unison, just pull the triggers. They just set up, and you see them sight for a second down their scopes, and then you see them pull. And like normally, Wally, you're actually used to like normal firearms where you hear the bark of the actual like, you know, the cracking sound of the gun firing off. These actually fire an energy laser out of them, like a high density energy photon type, you know, thing. Very similar actually to what Derwin uses.
Oh, lovely. So, miniature ion cannons.
And it slams into you guys. I need you both to roll me a fortitude check. And you have to beat a 20.
Pacha! Oh, nope.
Nope.
Sham Foxy isn't here to, like, be all upset at our awful rolls.
Now who's going to do all the work?
I mean,
we just kind of flail randomly. He actually hits people.
Yeah, but okay. He doesn't do any damage, like, ever.
Both of you sustain a single point of damage, which equates to each one of you gets a -1 to your toughness. However, Wally, particularly you, when it strikes you, it strikes you in a way that it actually kind of, like, sizzles your actual, like, nervous system a little bit, and you become dazed from the impact striking your person.
What kind of crazy ass bullets are these?
Ion cannon meets assault rifle.
Maybe.
So you still take one.
Okay.
However, on your next turn, you don't have a movement action.
What just happened? Okay, whatever. I think my toughness went down randomly.
No, he said that your toughness goes down by one for now.
Yep, your toughness.
So do I have an injury as well, or is it just the -1 toughness?
Do an injury and then also do a -1 toughness. That way you know how many you have to give yourself back when you eventually heal yourself.
Okay. How do I give myself a -1 toughness?
You go to points over on toughness and you click it down one.
I remember that my toughness is actually higher than that normally.
Well, that's why I have you write the injury in. That way you can basically just add that to your toughness.
Oh, I guess I could put that in my notes, too.
So I can't move, but I can still take a standard action?
You can take a free action and a standard action. If you want, you can still take your standard action and make it a move action, but then you spend your entire standard action moving.
Gotcha.
The combat music stopped, by the way.
It's still going.
For me.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's still going.
I cannot hear it at all. Okay.
Now who needs a new headset?
This is a new headset. Weird. Okay.
Okay. So also, just to remind you guys, basically the way that damage works in this game is every time you sustain a damage, which you can only sustain up a maximum of one a turn, unless there's like special abilities implied, that lowers your toughness by one. If at any point in time you become incapacitated and they strike you, you roll for possible death.
You dead.
So basically, it's your toughness goes down, and then the extent that they succeed over that toughness equates to what's happening to you. So in the case of, like, for you with your instance, Pika, is it succeeded at a distance high enough that it caused you to become dazed.
Okay.
So, like, the pain jarred you and dazed you. It wasn't that, like, there's something particularly special with these bullets.
Gotcha.
Just so you know. Lily, you're up next. What are you gonna do?
I am going to summon Clifford.
Clifford.
The big red corgi. Go, Clifford!
Why did that not come up? Hold on. I need to make sure that this showed up.
Clifford, the big red corgi. He's gonna come and eat your face. Clifford. He's so cute! Oh my god.
Yeah, you know you like that Photoshop job I did for your
Hells
corgi.
yeah. He's so cute. Look how adorable he is.
You can place him anywhere within 1 square of you. I just threw him there because I figured
That's
that's where you'd want
totally
him.
fine.
Okay, Lily, would you like to explain to Wally how you summoned Clifford? Because like they don't quite understand the awesomeness of how you summon your demons.
Basically, I reach into my backpack
Which looks like we gotta clarify the cuteness of the backpack.
My backpack?
Yeah, tell us about your backpack.
I thought my backpack was pretty normal.
Okay,
I
that's
don't
fine.
remember it being extra cute.
They're
Maybe
not
it's
gonna
like
be
a
like a
pink,
Dora backpack.
like a little pink and blue. No, fuck Dora.
Backpack. Okay.
It would be like an animal backpack, if anything.
Okay. What
But,
animal? A panda? Is it a
sure.
panda backpack?
Sure.
All right, panda backpack. You should add
Panda
that into your
backpack.
character
And
customization.
it's got like little patches of adorable like animal heads like sewn into it really poorly. And
Barbie doll heads. No.
Barbie doll heads just hanging from their hair. So I reach into my backpack and I kind of rifle through and then I bust out. Oh, wait, hang on.
Oh, this can't be good.
Oh god, she's gonna actually pull out a stuffed animal. Yeah, I knew it.
The one stuffed animal that I own.
You own one that's still in a can.
That's true, I do. And I bust out my stuffed puppy. This is a beagle,
Not a corgi.
not a corgi though. And I go, I don't know. Go, Clifford! And I throw him, and then I guess they get engulfed in like flame, or when I throw them, they just like looks like they're exploding in the flame. And
Okay.
then as it lands, it's kind of like Drop Bear, where it lands and it's just like woof. And then there's whatever it is. So
Okay, so she kind of Yu-Gi-Oh's this shit. Like
yes.
she like pulls out her like little stuffed animal and she's like, "Go, Clifford!" And she like wings it, and as it's like flying through the air,
I
just like
choose you.
billowing smoke pours from it. And like you can just absolutely smell like the smell of like burnt fur, flesh, and sulfur. And right before it lands, that smoke, out of the smoke, billows this fiery giant corgi. Okay, so next turn, Lily, I will have you play Clifford as well. I added him to the thing.
Oh, wait, hang on.
Also, I'd like you to roll an intimidation check. Oh, she's gonna take a minute. Because she's taking a minute, I am going to grab another drink. I will be right back.
Okay.
I will show you the completeness of my collection of animals. So this is my beagle. He watches over my home. And then I got canned black bear. I still haven't opened it. And it says, open only with adult supervision. These bears have been known to lie in wait under your covers and snuggle you to sleep. And then there's like a really long thing on the back.
Are you sure you're allowed to open that alone?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure I'm old enough, seeing as I'm like 30. So, remember, if you see any bears in the wild, do not go near them. Oh, it's like info about black bears and stuff. And it says, contents, one fuzzy black bear. So
Another.
that's my canned black bear that I keep on my mantle.
You have a mantle?
Yeah. It's got like a fireplace that doesn't work.
Oh, fair enough.
I had someone make this for me a long time ago. It's a little chick that's like in the shape of a ball. And there's an anime which I can't remember the name of. And there's like these little chibi, like destructive kid, like girls. And then there's like this little bird that's literally like a ball like this, and it like flies around and it lands on one of the chibi's heads and then poops on it and then just like flies off. It was awesome. So I have a little basketball bird. And then I have what's his face? Momoji. I've got Momoji from Samurai Champloo. Momoji is awesome.
It's better than a friend of mine. She has all she has is stuffed herpes.
Okay, back.
Stuffed what?
Herpes.
Herpes?
Yep. Legitimately, it's...
Oh, is it one of those, like, virus... stuffed virus things?
Yep.
This is, don't you know Momoji from Samurai Champloo? Jeez. Have you ever seen Samurai Champloo?
I think she's crazy.
No, it's Momoji. Momoji lives in, the main character, the main girl character's, like, inner kimono. Flies out. It's a little flying squirrel. It's got like a little scar on its belly. That's my collection. And there's like dice rolls happening. What's happening? Are we dying? Is that what's happening?
Okay. So, suddenly this giant infernal flaming corgi appears on the helipad to the great shock of everyone on the immediate vicinity, except for Lily. That's the only person that's not sure, and Derwin, because Derwin's totally just out of it at this point in time. And immediately that apparently has become the biggest threat, and all of Arachnos, the other six Arachnos members take their energy pistols and they aim at this flaming corgi and fire off. Lily, as far as these go, how does this match up with Clifford's dodge plus 10?
Clifford has a dodge of 24, so they miss.
Oh, good lord. whatsoever.
I gave him a really high dodge and parry, man.
So, like, they all, like pull back and they sight and fire. And, like, they do a fairly good job of that same strict military unison fire. And Clifford goes, and just bounces straight up. Like, it does that little tail wiggle that corgis do, and then it just bounces straight off the ground, and all the shots just go wide underneath, and then it lands, and you feel the helipad shake a little bit from the weight of the corgi.
Sorry. I'm reenacting it with my beagle. My cat's sitting on my table, like, right over here, and he's like, what the fuck is happening?
Wally, you're up, bro.
I'm gonna chuck the flashbang kind of towards the middle of them.
Can you click on the map with your left click and it'll create a circle for me so I can see where exactly?
Well, that...
Like, there, or...?
Like, well, something kind of... Like, is that gonna... I don't know the...
It's basically wherever you place it, it's got a two-square distance.
Two square, huh?
Yep.
My cat
so if you do it, like, right there...
I hit three people.
You would hit four from that distance.
Right here?
Actually, you'd hit five from that. You would hit this guy, the two lieutenants, this guy, and this guy. If you threw your flashbang right here.
We'll go with right there then.
Okay. I need you to roll me a, what is it? A throw. Just throw.
Athletics.
It's gonna be just a flat ranged combat for this one.
So I just roll a blank?
Yeah, roll the blank one. All of them see you wing this flashbang, and the two that are closest, like they get a better look at it, and you hear flash. And then all of them turn their head and look away from the flashbang as it blows, unaffected by it.
Lovely.
The soldiers, through the great worry of this giant corgi, flaming corgi, have also decided that this, especially after watching six energy shots go right past it, underneath it, they have ultimately decided that this is most definitely the most dangerous thing within their immediate path, and fire off.
No, he's adorable. Shots. He's not dangerous, he's just adorable. I like how I asked if they have cake, and I'm sitting here eating a brownie.
Well, we know what's on your mind.
Hey, man.
I was gonna go with corgis.
It's how I roll. I would love to own a corgi, man. No, I bought this with my lunch earlier, and my lunch was really big, so I couldn't eat the brownie, too.
Fair enough. Fair meow, enough.
Meow, meow.
Meow, 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 meow.
My cat's
meow,
still
meow,
sitting
meow,
here
meow.
On the corner of my table. Like, just like... just like, what is going on? And I have, like, a chair for him over here with a towel on it that he usually hangs out on.
Okay. Not only do they fire off these shots, where before they fired just, like, a quick little rapid shot, this one, they, like, spray lasers out of their assault rifles towards the corgi. This and this. How much did you say his dodge was?
It's 25? It's 14, but you said plus 10, so 24.
Okay. One of them strikes. So, like, one of them hits, and he kind of, like, wiggles and moves out of the way, and the other one slams into him. I need you to roll me a fortitude check. This'll be... Okay, that strikes him.
Okay.
So he takes one injury.
No!
And his toughness gets lowered by one.
No!
So it means... Just the sheer volume, even Clifford can't quite dodge that with its cute little, you know, wiggly butt. And it slams into his little, yeah, into his chest. And well, it doesn't seem to hurt him too much. He seems to kind of be, like, a little annoyed by this. And you hear this, like, deep grumble from this giant corgi in annoyance at their blasphemous attack against
Jack.
Him.
Let's put this guy away.
Okay, Lily, you are the next one on the list.